Right guys, here we go. It is the semi-final of the MLS Cup Eastern Conference, and we have drawn Orlando City, our rivals. Now we've had two previous meetings. The last game we drew 3-3, and the one before that we won away 2-1. So they have been close games. But we're going to set up exactly the same in this game like we did for the 3-3 for the 3-3 draw, but play a little bit differently if we go behind. So we win this game, we go right to the final of the MLS Cup with a chance to win it all. If we don't, if we get beat, potentially this is the last game of the Inter Miami season 2 season in the series. So they were drawn Orlando City. Training has been prepared by Jason Christ, the assistant manager. We've had people come back from injuries apart from Robert Taylor, who picked up tight Achilles, but he wasn't going to be in the squad anyway. And we're 5-4 favourites on to win the game. The draws are 5-2, and Orlando City are 2-1. And they've got a few injuries as well. Antonio Carlos is suspended, Alexander Pato and Gaston Gonzalez are unavailable for selection, so they've got a few injuries, but we're also on course to set a record. So we've won 23 matches this season, the record's 24 for the most ever. So if we win this game, we will equal the record set by LA Galaxy. And obviously if we win the final, we'll break the record. So one hell of a season, no doubt. So he attended the press conference. The question was, do you agree that this could be seen as a bit of a grudge match between Oscar Perez and yourself, given his comments about you after your last encounter? And I replied with, not really, no. I'm trying to not treat this match differently to any other. Whatever Oscar said or says won't affect our preparation. And he basically just said the same thing, but he said, I wouldn't call any game of football a grudge match. This just reeks of the media trying to stir up issues that aren't there. But then they came back after that, the press, and it said, Massive Marquez has been surprisingly blasé about the importance of the upcoming match to his fans. Do you share this view about the lack of importance of this match? And he replied with, I was surprised by Massive Marquez's comments. This is a match the fans want their teams to be given everything in, and it looks to me like they might not be up for it, up for the fight. We're going to throw it, but we're just not trying to get carried away, and we're going to treat it like any other game. That's basically what I said. But the board expectations, the board expect us to win this game, and the supporters' expectations expect us to win as well. So, high stakes. Drake Callender can play the full match. He's going to be on the bench. George Acosta, he can play 45 minutes, but he's not going to be on the bench, which you're going to see now. So this is the team that I'm going with for this game. It's basically, I would say it's our best team possible, really. With the five at the back, and then the two mid, we've got the ball winner midfielder with Gregori and John Motta, the attacking centre midfielder with an attacking role. We've got Rodriguez and Robinson, and obviously Higuain. Look at the link-ups there. Now, mentality is going to be attacking because we get the home advantage, because our seed was lower at the start of the season, so we get home advantage in this game. So attacking mentality. When we're in possession, fairly wide. Our approach play, again, play our defence, overlap on the left and right. the final third. Run at the defence, be more disciplined, shoot on sight. In transition, counter press when the ball was being lost. Possession's being won, go on the counter, roll it out with the goalkeeper. When we're out of position, that high line of engagement, that high press, and a much lower line of engagement to basically force the opponents to make a long shot rather than trying to get in behind. We're going to trap on the outside, which means try and force them out wide as well. And it's been working for us this season in my own formation, domination formation, which if we win the whole thing will be legendary really, won't it? But yeah, this game is a one game, one leg, so if it's a draw after 90 minutes it goes to extra time and penalties, and we can play either Atlanta or New York City FC in the final. Let's see the semi-final. And it looks like Atlanta United have beaten New York City FC. So, yeah. We need to win this game to get into the final. It's always a massive deal, isn't it, to be in a Football Manager final. The other games are Seattle 1, Minnesota 1, obviously San Jose. They play against Real Salt Lake. But yeah, massive game for us, the biggest game we've had so far. And we've overachieved this season. The goal was to get into the top seven, really, into the playoff places, and see where we went from there. But we've actually done a lot more than that. You both feel you're doing an unbelievable job, and you're clearly the right manager for the job. And there we go, look. Reached the MLS playoffs, that was the current season objective. So we've done that. Become an established support shield team. We won that. The only failure was getting into the latter stages of the US Cup. But I hold my hands up. Not being an experienced MLS player, I didn't realise the squad requirements for the US Cup. And that's where our downfall was, really, I think. But yeah. We finished top of the league season by 12 points that you can see there, but it's semi-final time. Analysis of their attacking and defensive performance indicates that they are generally alright defensively, but they are very good in attack. We will have to stay very sharp to come out with the result. Yeah, I know we will. Opposition instructions, it's important to always trigger a press when the ball is played to Rodrigo Schlegel or Schlegel to improve our chances of winning. I think we should tell our players to not hold back when tackling Facundo Torres. He scored, I think it was 2 or 3 in the 3-3 draw earlier in the season. It would be sensible to go in hard but fair on Erk and Cara. I'm going to do that. So they're a good team. If you watch that 3-3 match, if you want to go back and watch it, we were actually 2-0 up, and then they brought it back, and then went 3-2 up, then we had to get an equaliser. So we should have really went defensive when we went 2 up, really. So I'm not going to do anything else, I'm not going to reduce defend duties or anything like that. I'm just going to listen to the opposition instructions and then see how we fare. So I think that's it. Let's go. It's a bit of a mixed reaction. Encouraged and mixed and pleased. is the feedback we get from Jason Christ, the assistant manager, about our setup, our system. It's my own domination formation, so let's see if this system can get me through to the Football Manager final. Into Miami, Nick Marsman, Andre Yedlin, Imre Mbeka, Christian McVeigh, Ryan Searle, Kieran Gibbs, Aguero, Joao Mota, Bobby Robinson, Emerson Rodriguez, Gonzalo Higuain, the captain, Pedro Galese, Ruan, Rodrigo Schlegel, Robin Jansen, Jean Martinho, Cartagena, Arujo, Angulo, Pereira, the captain, Facundo Torres, and Erkin Cara. Single start, so that's good. We've been struggling to pick a hole in this team. Look forward to this. That's our best team. Shouldn't have to tell you how much this means to the fans. Do it for them. Yeah, I'm going to go with that. Do you hope your team can produce today? I hope for a performance in every match, like everyone else. It's Derby Day, how much do you look forward to taking on your local rivals? It means more to the fans than anyone else, but we have to look at it just like another match. Any team changes likely for this one? I'm not willing to discuss any tactical details before the match. So let's go. Easy ball. good start. Keeping the ball well. Good position. This is better. Well, I think we're the better team so far. All of this crap that we're not ready for it, but hopefully looks like he was wrong. To be better in them moments. So free kick. corner. Shot. So far, so push out, well done. Thank you. Well done. Let's see, get out. Easy ball. Thank you. for a goal. The ball. Thank you. 5 minutes. 1 minute to go. We've done it. We're in the final. The final. Look at those stats. 24 shots over there, 4. 9 shots on target, they are none. We had 3.49 XG over there, 0.11. Probably our best of the season so far. 8 corners over there, 1. 17 fouls over there, 10. That, but we do play that way on purpose. They had 2 yellow cards over our 1. We had 88% pass completion, they had 83%. We had 54% possession, they had 46%. We put out a fantastic performance according to our XG. The XG was far greater than our opponents. Best performer was DeAndre Yedlin. And yeah, I probably agree. Probably a perfect performance. We couldn't have asked for any more there. And we're in the final. We're in a Football Manager final. Nice work, everyone. That was good. Not many people would have predicted the MLS Eastern Conference final place for Inter Miami. How good does this moment feel? I'm so proud of this team. It's been quite the adventure and it's not over yet. You've been on a good run lately, but that was something else. I agree, actually. Look at that, dressing room atmosphere, excellent, managerial support, good, team cohesion, good. There are a few better things than being in the middle of a club where morale is this high. How long can you continue to maintain that? I'm not going to talk about it for fear of jinxing things. The crude result, can't believe how good we were. More of the same in the next match. Oh man, what a great result, I'll be buzzing all week. Being able to watch players like Yedlin is why I love this job. Can't complain about the win. Can't complain about the team effort. Can't complain about Yedlin's performance. I love Yedlin. Yeah, I'm basically saying we had too many wasted chances. We did really, we should have scored more. Scenes. I'm gonna save you. I can't believe we're in a final. It's my own tactics and that. My own system. I haven't downloaded any tactics ever. And it's paid off. I've just done my homework. And we're in a final. MLS Eastern Conference, Catania bids farewell to Orlando City. Inter Miami ensured that while the Coutinho played his last game for Orlando City, he could not end his Lions career on a high as they won 2-0. Veteran striker Gonzalo Higuain gave into Lyon with a lead with a powerful close range effort in the 35th minute. An error from Orlando City's Fernando Torres allowed experienced fullback Kieran Gibbs to score a volley in the 6-yard box. Orlando City's Justavan was forced off with a broken toe in the 88th minute following an attempted tackle with Gonzalo Higuain. Hit that like. Inter Miami win the MLS Eastern Conference semi-final. Inter Miami are through to the final after a 2-0 win over Orlando City. The likes of Gonzalo Higuain and John Motta were key to the league leaders' remarkable success this season, scoring 31 goals between them in all competitions. I agree. Pressure. Marquez wouldn't send the team out to hurt the opposition. Julian Justavan was an unfortunate casualty against Inter Miami. Many have claimed play too close to the edge and often cross the line on what might be considered acceptable physicality. What do you make of their style and approach? He said, I don't believe Marquez would ever send a team out to inflict injury or to deliberately dirty. They're abrasive and combative, but that's how they want to play, so good luck to them. That's right, that is our play. Wow, Inter Miami to play Atlanta United in the final. So that'll be the next game. Inter Miami play Atlanta United FC in the MLS Eastern Conference final. The game will be played at Exploria Stadium on the 30th of October. Both teams are in especially good form as of late. A bumper crowd is expected, what will undoubtedly be a fascinating and hard-fought tie. Inter Miami will have to watch out for creative forces like Luis Araujo, who tops the assist charts in the MLS Eastern Conference this season. The current holders of the competition are New York City FC. Yeah, so we're playing at Exploria Stadium, a neutral ground. It holds 25,000. Yedlin on form as Inter Miami score easy victory. The defender played superbly and looked really comfortable on the ball. Yedlin has made 105 interceptions, 69 tackles in 34 appearances for Inter Miami this season. He was brought to the MLS in 2013 by Seattle from their academy, and I'm going to praise his performance. I thought you were outstanding defensively last time. I'll keep up the good work. Great having this talk with you. Let me know if you need anything else. Thanks, I'll keep doing what I'm doing. Post-match press conference. Here we go. You must feel even better about the result given the pre-match war of words between you and Oscar Pereja. Is it fair to say that the exchange gave you a bit of extra motivation? He was quoted as saying, I don't think so. Massive Marquez isn't someone I rate all that highly. He's not cut out for a game of this magnitude. And he'll be feeling, yeah, I can remember him saying that. Oh, well, he's laughing now, good. We tried to play the match rather than the occasion. Getting a good result was the important thing, and we're very pleased with the way things went out there. We managed to extend into Miami's impressive run over Orlando City. How do you feel about the particular record? I couldn't care less about the so-called record. I was pleased with the result, and it's always nice to keep these things going wherever possible. It lifts morale and it gives us a slight edge every time we meet. I'll get a little dig in there. Congratulations on winning the playoffs. How do you feel that your team are shaping up ahead of the next challenge in the competition I've just played Orlando City. Just being arrow with that one. I've made it a rule to not only look at the next game. There's not much I can really comment on any specific way at the moment. You managed to grab the win today against Orlando City. What did you make of the game? I'm delighted. It's a great win and something for the fans to celebrate too. Orlando City had a poor day in front of goal, failed to register a single shot on target. Are you delighted with the stat? I think it was as a complete performance that we could have hoped for, and I'm very pleased. Yeah, I am. We were all surprised to see Kieran Gibbs pop up with a goal, as you must have been too. It was a great moment for Kieran and we're all delighted for him. So yeah. So 9 days we've got, and yeah, it's the final against Atlanta United. If you look at the previous meetings, let's have a look. So the previous meetings against Atlanta United. We lost 1-0 there, and we won 1-0, so we won one and lost one against Atlanta. We won at home and we lost away. This is on a neutral ground, so it's fitting really. Explore your stadium. But yeah, we win the match, win the semi-final, we're in the final now, the Eastern Conference against Atlanta United. It'll be a hard game because I can remember every time we played them, it's been close and they've been a really good team. But yeah, we move on, don't we? We move on. I'll do my best to prepare for that one. But yeah, we've got a chance to win the Eastern Conference Final. So I'll think about what team I'm going to play, but bye for now, got homework to do.